Is partial order good enough for constructing deterministic distributed algorithms? It turns out it may be sufficient for many situations. The airline reservation example I started with will work fine with the partial order of events dictated by Lamport's clock. But there are situations where there may be a need for a total order of events in the distributed system. Let's look at an example. Here is an example to illustrate the need for a total order. I'm going to use my own personal life example to illustrate the need for total order. I have one car, and my family consists of my wife, my son, and my daughter, and we share this single car. And what we want to do is make sure that we can make local decision on who gets dibs on using the car at any point of time. And we're going to use Lamport's clock for this. So what we do is, whenever we want to get the car for our personal use, we're going to text everyone with a timestamp. I'm going to associate a timestamp. If I'm requesting the car, I'm going to text everyone and associate a timestamp with that request. And it is a logical timestamp. And similarly, my wife would do the same thing, son and daughter, all of us do the same thing. And how do we pick the winner? Well, locally, we can look at the timestamp of requests that have come in from others and my own requests, and whoever has the earliest timestamp wins. Pretty simple, right? So pretty simple, everybody's going to make a local decision looking at the timestamps of requests that have come in from others and say, well, you know, right now it's my son's turn to use the car or my daughter's turn to use the car and so on. But what if the timestamp, because these are locally generated by each one of us, happens to be the same? So for instance, let's say my son makes a request, sends a text message. My son makes a request, sends a text message with a timestamp 10 to all of us. So this is the blue arrow that's going everywhere. So that's indicating to all three of us that he wants the car. And timestamp 10 is when he generated the request. So happens, my wife also makes a request for using the car exactly with the same timestamp 10. And that's the purple arrow that you're seeing. So now we have a problem. And the problem is, all of us are looking at these text messages and trying to make a decision who's got the dibs on using the car. How will my son and my wife know, given that both the timestamp is the same, which one is the winner for using this car? Now, what we do is we're going to break the tie, and I'm going to stipulate that age wins. And therefore, in this case, if the timestamp happens to be exactly the same, then my wife, by seniority, is the winner. She gets the car. So that's how we break the tie. You can see through this example that there is a need for total order in decision making when you have a distributed system. And you want to make local decisions without bothering anyone based on information that you have, but you have to make that local decision unambiguously, because you cannot have both my son and wife thinking that they have the car at the same time. That'll be a problem. So whenever there is a tie, we have to break that, and that's the need for the total order.